His goodness comes to you. Oh, yes, comes to you through the preaching of the gospel. The gospel, the good news that Christ Jesus died for our sins according to the scriptures, the Bible. Yes, Christ Jesus came, died for our sins. He was crucified. He was buried, and on the third day, he rose from the dead. The gospel, I know. Hallelujah, I say that. Praise be to Jehovah Jireh, my provider, the Prince of Peace, Jesus Christ. But if you continue in sin, young man, you're going to burn in hell. I don't want anyone to go to hell. I don't want anyone tormented in the lake of fire. I don't want anyone to ignore or to suppress the truth and end up in hell. Hell is terrifying. No warning is too strong. I got to warn you. I know the terror of the Lord. I try to persuade men and women to get right with God. Don't be a pervert. Don't be a lesbian. Don't be ungodly. Don't continue in sin. Don't be a God-hater. Oh, forgive your parents. Oh, yeah, come in humility before God. Lay down your pride. Your pride is before your fall, America. You're not a nation under God. See, you're in rebellion against the living God. You're in rebellion, but God, in his mercy and his kindness, stretches out his hand to you again and says, repent, repent, confess your sin, and Jesus Christ will be faithful and just to cleanse you from all unrighteousness. You've sinned against God. You've broken his law. You've broken his moral commandments. You have a moral accountability now. You're responsible. Oh, man, don't worship the devil. He's a fallen angel. See, you've been deceived by Satan, who has come to steal, kill, and destroy you. I'm talking about the Almighty God who rose from the dead, Jesus Christ, the God-man, the one you're going to stand before, the one who is described in the Holy Bible, sent the Holy Spirit to convict you of sin. It's basic. I'm just giving you the basics, the ABCs. You've sinned against God, but God is merciful. He's full of grace and kindness, and he comes to convict men of sin. That's why you feel bad if you're a sodomite. That's why you spit on me. You spit on me because I'm telling you the truth. If there is no God, you have no problem. If Mickey Mouse is God, then serve him. But men, I say, Jesus Christ, oh, you get upset. You spit on me. You cuss me out. You hate me. And I'm pointing you to paradise. I'm telling you about heaven. I'm telling you about eternal life. I'm telling you, you're going to live forever. You're going to live forever. Eternity is in your heart. You're going to live forever in the presence of God. And you're going to live in the lake of fire, burning, weeping, wailing, gnashing your teeth. You're in eternal torment forever and ever and ever. I don't want anyone to go to hell. I don't want you being burning in hell. I'm concerned about your soul. I am. I'm concerned. That's why I come out here. I plead with you to get right with God. I plead with you to get right with God. God is angry with the wicked every day. God used to be angry with me, but now his mercy, his grace, his loving kindness has forgiven me. You know why? I know. Satan is a liar. Satan is a loser. Satan is lost. He's lost. Jesus Christ. He is the one that rose from the dead. Jesus Christ, he is the one that's going to return and judge the living and the dead. You're about ready to die. Oh, you can exercise. You can take your vitamins. You can try to save your life. Oh, no, man. On the day your heart stops beating, if God requires your soul, you die of a heart attack running this race. Oh, I tell you, absent from the body, you're in the presence of the living God, Jesus Christ. And he stretched out his hand to you. He stretched out his hand to you. He convicted you of having sex out of marriage, looking at pornography, indulging in alcohol, lying, your pride. He convicted you when you were a sodomite or a lesbian. God is faithful. His loving kindness to come to discipline, spank, chastise, reveal to the conscience. You have a conscience. Some of you still have a conscience with knowledge of what is right and wrong. I'm telling you. I am blessed. I want you to be blessed. Blessed is the man whose sins are not imputed to him. Blessed is that man whose sins are not accounted. My sins are forgiven. My sins are forgiven. What about you? On the day of judgment. On the day of judgment. God speaking to you. Is God speaking to you? Huh? Is this a sign from God? A sign from God? I bring you a sign that you might hear the truth, and the truth would set you free from the bondage you are in of your sin. The bondage of sin, you're a slave to your sin, your addiction. No, man. You don't understand the seriousness, the danger of sin. Sin destroys. The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. The law comes and reveals to you, you're a sinner.
Love yourself.
Oh, Jesus Christ loves you enough to come to reprove and rebuke. That's wicked. It's ungodly. It's ungodly to be a pervert. It pleases God for you to walk holy, upright, set apart, clean, pure. Not to do what is evil in the sight of God. Evil. What is evil? Your selfish ambition, your pride is evil. Your outburst of anger, your lies, your bitterness. What is evil? Evil is you running down the street naked. Evil is your imagination as you look at pornography. It's evil in the sight of God. And God is willing to forgive and cover and cleanse and change. God is willing. Put some clothes on. That is filthy rotten. That is wicked. Man, shame on you. Shame on you. Will anybody rebuke that? Will anybody tell you the truth? Or, hey, everything that feels good, just do it. Whatever feels good, you're going to do it?
Is this connected to this?
No. Hey, I'm concerned.
Yeah,
I'm concerned.
You guys are enjoying your run. You're running straight to hell.
I don't want you to run straight to hell.
Enjoy the road. No. Enjoy the road to hell.
No, man. See?
It's easy.
I know. It's wide and it's easy. You're right. The road to hell, he's exactly right. It's wide and it's easy. And sin is fun. Sin is fun. But when you get AIDS, when you get a venereal disease, when you get that new strain of herpes, oh man, put some clothes on. Put some clothes on. I'll tell you, will anybody tell him the truth? I am concerned about where you're going to spend eternity. Is anybody concerned about that?
Right.
Amen. When you die,
these look like eternity to me.
When you die, man, and you stand before God, you're going to remember every time God stretched out his hand to forgive, to cleanse, to change. And then why do you want to serve devils? Why do you want to do what is perverted? Why do you want to ignore God's loving kindness as he comes to you to rebuke you or discipline you or speak to your conscience about the way you are living? The way you're living, the way you're acting, your pride, your outburst of anger, your lust, your perversion, that is not good. It is evil and wicked in the sight of God, but God is merciful. He's merciful. He's full of mercy, full of loving kindness. He's full of goodness. And that is his goodness that comes out to you today to describe to you your sin that you might repent, think differently about God, think differently about sin, your lifestyle, think differently about the way you talk, the way you think, the way you act, and your pride. Oh, you got to humble yourself. You got to humble yourself. You got to call upon the name of the Lord. You got to turn from your ungodly lifestyle, your ungodly attitude. Quickly, time is running out.
Hey, Jesus, Lord,
God is going to require your soul. And I'm trying to point you to prepare. Prepare to meet your God. Prepare. Prepare to stand before the living God, Jesus Christ, who suffered and died for you, who commands you to turn. Turn from doing what is ungodly. Turn. Turn from your hatred and your... Oh, yes, and their filthy language and the things that come out of you. Your heart is deceitful. Your heart is wicked. It's selfish. It's a dog-eat-dog world, man. You don't see sin? Sin is all around us. There's evil. There's what is wicked. And God wants to deliver you from your lying. Yes, from your perversion. From you being a lesbian or a homosexual or a pervert or a baby-killing people who have rejected Jesus Christ. You need to repent. You need to repent. Turn quickly. Today is the day. You can believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and your sins will be blotted out. And times of refreshing will come from the presence of the Lord. Oh yeah, you need to be converted. You need to be changed by the power and the love and the goodness of God that you no longer practice sin. You no longer live in rebellion. You no longer live in disobedience. You no longer do what you want. You no longer govern your life and sit on your throne. You have no right, people. You have no right to flip God off. No wonder he throws the wicked into hell. No wonder he throws the sodomite into hell. No wonder he throws the liar into hell. Because you will not change. You think God's going to let your sin into his kingdom? The kingdom of God? He has allowed you to walk on his earth and you have trampled it with your sin and pornography. You have trampled it with smoking marijuana, indulging in alcohol, and living a selfish life as you hurt one another and lie to one another. Oh, but God will forgive. God will cover your sins. Jesus Christ died. Yes, Jesus Christ is the one that can rescue you. How will you escape if you neglect so great a salvation? How are you going to escape damnation? How are you going to escape the wrath, the anger, the vengeance of God upon the wicked and the ungodly? Who is wicked and ungodly? Those who lie. Have you ever lied? Oh, that's wicked. It's wicked to lie. How about have sex out of marriage? Premarital sex. Oh, that's wicked. How about masturbating? How about masturbating? Oh, that's wicked. When you look at a woman, you lust after her, and you commit adultery in your heart. Oh, that's wicked. Oh, God is not pleased with sodomy. God is not pleased with butt sex. No way. On the day of judgment, when you stand before him, he'll show you that he destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah. He has shown you that the hearts of men were, the imagination of the thoughts of men were evil continually, and that's why he had to flood the earth. Oh, people, you don't even see your wickedness. You got demons. You sacrifice to devils. You have allowed Satan, Lucifer, the Antichrist, to come into your life. You need deliverance. 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 You need to be delivered, man. That's why you flip me off. Because there is a God. He is holy. He is pure. He is righteous. He's revealed himself in the Holy Bible. He's revealed himself in Jesus Christ. And you have to deal with your guilty conscience. You have to deal with your guilty conscience. You have to deal with your pain that you don't know who you are, your identity. You don't know your position. You don't know anything about it. And then you act like that. You act like that. I love you enough to tell you the truth. I love you enough to tell you that a day is coming when your heart's going to stop beating. 10 out of 10 die. Everyone dies. And absent from the body, we stand before who? The Creator. All of creation reveals his invisible attributes, his divine nature, his eternal power. No one's going to have an excuse. There is no God. God has made it evident to every one of you. And you know your sin. And that's why you're responding the way you are towards me, cussing me out, saying all kinds of evil, spitting on me. Guys, you need to get some clothes on. That's ungodly. Shame on you. It's wicked. Would anybody tell you that God made clothes and that's why you put clothes on? Man, it's simple. It's simple. God has made it clear. Read the Bible. Get to know the God of the Bible. The Bible is clear about your sin and rebellion. How you live, how you act, the way you talk, the things you do. It's in opposition to God. You've offended God. You offend God running down the street with no clothes on, guys. You're accountable. You're accountable. It's a perversion. Oh, sin, fag, sicko. That's what San Francisco is. It's a full of sin and diseases. Diseases. Oh, and you're not even going to stop the gonorrhea. You can't even stop what is taking place in the land. Oh, you're in danger, America. I warned you. I warned you, you're in danger. Oh, on the day you die and you stand before the living God, you're going to remember every time God stretched out his hand to you. God was willing to forgive. God was willing to cleanse. God demonstrated his love while yet you were a sinner. Jesus Christ died upon the cross. But you have rejected his love. You have rejected his mercy. You have suppressed the truth. You live in a lie. And I'm bidding you to come out. Come out from among them. Come out from the wicked. The road is broad that leads to hell. Many, it's fun to sin. You're running on down the road into sin. Oh, but I'm telling you, the consequences of sin, the sting of sin is death. And the strength of that death is the law of God. The law shows you you're a criminal. You're guilty. Guilt is good. Guilt is good. Don't hail Satan. Worship Jesus Christ in spirit and in truth. Describe to him his greatness. He is awesome. You are sinners. Sinners. You live in sin. That's wicked. That's wicked. What you do, how you speak, how you live, you are accountable. Every idle word you speak, you're going to give an account of it on the day of judgment. I warned you. I warned you. I tried to persuade you to flee from the wrath that is coming. I told you Jesus Christ is going to return. And the wicked are turned into hell. And all the nations have forgotten God. That's why you need to consider this, people. Consider this. Lest you forget God and you are torn to pieces. You're not a nation under God. There's no fear of God. There's no reverence for God. There's no respect for God. As you look like a pervert, a sicko running down the street. Come on, where's holiness? Where's righteousness? Where's purity? Where is those things that are clean and good, that God loves to look upon and we're blessed? No, what has happened to America, what has happened to America is an ungodly people doing ungodly things, unholy, living for self, living for lust, living for pleasure, living for entertainment, anything to make them feel good, but you're never satisfied. You're never satisfied, just another beta breaker, another year. Run down the street. Oh, does it make you feel good now? Are you feeling good now? I tell you, you're empty. You're empty. You're losers. Empty. You understand the vanity of life, the meaninglessness of life. This is it. Run down the street. You feel good. Another party, San Francisco, another beta breaker. It's sad because you're going to die. God is going to require your soul. Oh, I know God loves me, but I'm worried about you. Your lifestyle makes him angry. Yeah, your lifestyle is sodomy. Your lifestyle, sex out of marriage. Your lifestyle, looking at pornography. Your lifestyle of indulging in liquor and getting wasted. Yeah, your lifestyle of lying, covetousness, the love of money. The lifestyle of your pride, your arrogance, and your filthy words. God does not. That offends him. That offends God. You have offended God, but God is merciful. No, don't offend him. God is not mocked. God is not mocked. Whatever a man sows, that's what he will reap. You're going to reap the consequences of your sin, America. You have rebelled against God, but God will forgive you. Will you humble yourself? Will you repent? Will you turn? Will you surrender? Oh, will you get right with him? Not the way. Not if you continue to sin. You're not going to continue to sin. The grace may abound. I'm telling you, God commands you to repent from your sin. A command. Not a suggestion. You must be born again to enter into the kingdom of God. You must turn from your rebellion, your bad attitude. It's your attitude. It's your behavior, the way you live, the way you think and act, in rebellion against God. You don't submit to God. You don't obey him. You don't think about him. You don't worship him. You don't acknowledge him. You don't give thanks to him. You think it's you. You are the one that can keep yourself healthy running down the road. Oh, I'm telling you, on the day of judgment, on the day of judgment, I warned you, you will remember every time God's word came out, God convicted you, and you're going to be tormented by the truth you know in hell. You're going to be tormented. No, it's your conscience. Your conscience is what bothers you, not me. You're guilty, you know your sin, and you try to suppress it with liquor, with running, with all of that, everything of this world, but you cannot get rid of the guilt. You can't get rid of the pain. You can't get rid of the loneliness, the insecurity, the emptiness, the boredom. Oh, another party. What are you going to do after you run? Oh, eat something. Yeah, what do you do? Oh, drink. Yeah, that's it. That's all you got. Liquor. Liquor to heal the wounds and the pain, but they're still there. I'm saying come to him. Jesus Christ for healing. Jesus Christ will bring life. Oh, on the day of judgment. On the day of judgment, I'm going to tell you, God is not mocked. God is not mocked, people. Whatever a man sows, that's what he's going to reap. You sow to the flesh, from the flesh you're going to reap corruption. That's why you got AIDS. That's why you got herpes. That's why you got venereal diseases. Because of your promiscuity, your lasciviousness. You know what that word is, lasciviousness? That's what's lewd and vile. That's what goes through your mind. All that kinky and perverted and sick and ungodly things. Oh, I tell you.
Hello, America!
Oh, I tell you, America is in danger. America is going to be judged. America is going to be wiped out. I mean, you don't see the signs. You don't see. You think you can do whatever you want, whenever you want, and that you're okay. Oh, no, you're not okay. Because you have offended God. You've sinned against God. God is the one that you're going to give an account to. All your secret sins, all your secret life, all the skeletons in the closet throughout your life, nothing will be hidden. Everything will lay bare on the day of judgment. Everything will be known. Everything will be naked. Oh yeah, you'll be known. All your secret sins. Everything, every way you live and you act in rebellion and pride and arrogance and your vainglory. America, you need to repent and give your life to Jesus Christ. You must be born again or you will not enter the kingdom of God. I warn you. You have to turn and change the way you're acting. Change the way you're living. Change the way.
Jesus saves, brother.
Oh, Jesus saves. I know he saved me. What about you? What is he saved from? What is he saved from? He saves from the punishment of sin, hellfire. The wicked are turned into hell. The wicked are turned into hell. And all those who forget God. Do you understand? If you think you can get rid of God, you can't get rid of your conscience. You can't get rid of your guilt, your shame. You can't get rid of it. It's there. It's there in every one of you when you know. You have broken God's law. You have done what is wicked. No, hell is going to be terrifying, people. This is love. This is love. Telling you the truth. I'm loving on you. You've just never been loved this way before. Then anyone told you the truth. The truth about having sex out of marriage. It's wrong. The truth about sleeping with another woman, being a lesbian, is wrong. Oh, the truth about sodomy, it is wrong. I'm going to tell you what is wrong because God tells you what is wrong and right. What he likes and what he dislikes. What is light and what is dark. Jesus said, I am the light of the world and whoever follows me will not walk in darkness. You're walking in darkness. You are blind. Put some clothes on. Shame, shame. Put some clothes on. Wicked. You take that which was supposed to be sacred and you make it common. Common. You cheapen it. You cheapen it.
I'm having more fun than you.
No, you're not having any fun. What is fun running down a broad road to hell? What is fun? Your sin for a season and then it reaps what? The consequences of herpes when you have sex out of marriage. Venereal disease. AIDS. Oh, man, you get twisted and perverted like that guy or that thing or that it or that whatever. I don't even know if the gender, I don't even know what you are. Girl, boy, it, what? Next you're going to say you can marry a dog. You can have sex with your cat. I mean, that's how perverted you get. That's how sick. That's how sick the demons, the devils, will take you down to that perverted road. You know exactly what I'm talking about, huh? Oh, you know the perversion that runs through your mind because you give in.